On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet cove of Cork. We were sailing away with the cargo of bricks from the Grand Central Hall in New York. 'Twas an elegant craft, rigged fore and aft. How the wild wind drove her! She could stand a great blast, and had 27 masts, and they called her the Irish Rover. We had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags. We had 2 million barrels of stone. We had 3 million sides of old blind horses' hides. We had 4 million barrels of bone. We had 5 million dogs, 6 million hogs, 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million bales of old Nanny Goat's tails in the hold of the Irish Rover. There was old Mickey Coote, who played hard on his flute when the ladies lined up for a set. He was tooting with skill for each sparkling trill. Quences were fluted and bet. With his smart, witty talk, he was cock of the walk. Rolled the dames under and over. They all knew at a glance, when he took up his stance, that he sailed in the Irish Rover. There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee. There was Hogan, the County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, he was scared stiff of work, and the chap from Westmeath called Malone. There was Slugger O'Toole, drunk as a mule, fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. And your man Mick McCann from the banks of the Bann, and was called Skipper of the Irish Rover. We had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out, and our ship lost its way in the fog. And that whale of the crew was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's old dog. Then the ship struck a rock, oh Lord, what a shock. The boat, it flipped right over, turned 9 times around, and the poor dog was drowned, and the last of the Irish Rover. It turned 9 times around, and the poor dog was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish Rover.